Good morning, everybody. Good morning, ladies. It's a pleasure to address to you just briefly and say hello, and I really wish you a great success for the next 2 days of your conference. First of all, you can imagine that the topic and the framework of the conference is of high relevance and of high interest of the Heinrich Böll Foundation. For us and for the Green Party we are affiliated with, gender equality, equal rights, and women's access to all kinds of resources is a core issue. We address this issue through all our programs and projects worldwide, and I'm proud to tell you that we are really able, as Heinrich Böll Foundation, not just to briefly address the issue, but really go into detail and deeply, and we really would like to look into the issue of why. What are the root causes of gender equality worldwide? I'm convinced there can't be democracy without equal rights for women. And as I already said, for us, social justice is only if there are equal rights, equal participation of women in the economic, in the political, and as well in the private sphere. The foundation is therefore addressing the issue of gender equality in all our programs and projects worldwide. We try to help to empower women to fight for their rights, and we try to bring a gender perspective in all different issues, different political areas, macroeconomic area, peace and security. Just to make clear that it's not just a lip service that we look into cross-cutting issues, but for example, I'm deeply convinced that without a gender perspective in conflict prevention, we will lose what we'd like to address, prevent conflicts, because there are highly gender-relevant issues around the issue of conflicts and prevention. I think what we share, you and me, our partners in Nigeria, South Africa, and Kenya, and we here at the headquarters in Berlin, is that we all know and experienced for a long while, I would say, that legislation, instruments like quotas, gender machineries are a very important prerequisite for gender equality, but it's definitely not enough. We have to change stereotypes, gender stereotypes, and we have to change culture in very different societies, I have to say. Stereotypes and discrimination against women are deeply rooted in different cultures, and this is why we have to address these cultures. How to overcome discrimination, how to overcome gender stereotypes. And this is why I'm so happy that you are going to address patriarchy as a root cause of that kind of discrimination. I'm deeply convinced that cultures are shaped by patriarchy, and this is why I'm really happy that you are going to address that issue over the next days. We know legislation. If we know that legislation is not enough, if we know that instruments like quotas are important but not sufficient, then we definitely have to look into strategies how to address these stereotypes. And this is why, again, I would say congratulations for our HBS offices in South Africa, Nigeria, and Kenya to open the door for a real self-reflection process. What kind of strategy do work? What kind of strategy did not work over the last years? We need from time to time space and time to rethink and reflect our strategies in order to be ready to reset our strategies and to continue to struggle and fight. I think frustration is not the right answer. We need our joint efforts, we need motivation, and I think we definitely need to be empowered in order to continue our fights for gender democracy, for gender equality. And in that respect, I wish you all the best, inspiring debates, real good discussions over the next coming days. And I'm sure that I will get to know what you discussed so far. And I would like to let you know that we will make sure that your recommendations will be definitely considered by our offices in Nigeria, in Kenya, and in South Africa. Thank you so much for being with us. Thank you so much for sharing your ideas, your recommendations, and I'm sure you will have a great time together, and have just goodbye and all the best for you.